This is the morning report. Gives you the long and the short. Every grunt, roar and snort. Not a tale I distort. On the morning report.
Hi boys and girls, welcome to week two of the morning report. Hope you've had a super duper weekend. Do you know what days are in the weekend? There's 2 days, both beginning with a S. What 2 days do we have in the weekend? Saturday and Sunday. So today is the first day of a new week, and Mrs. Holly has put a YouTube link on there so you can listen to a song about the day. What day is it? Monday. Well done. Let's read the date together. Monday, the 30th of March 2020. Happy Monday, everyone.
What's the weather? What's the weather? What's the weather like today? All together, what's the weather like today?
Number of the week is a super big one. Who knows what number it is? Have a look on the screen. It's a 2 and a 0. Don't tell me yet. Are you ready? After 3, 1, 2, 3. It's 20. Super work. Do we think we can do 20 great big claps? Should we have a go? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Fantastic. Good counting. Well done. Now, I have got 20 Numicon here. Can you see them? I want to know who can have a go at counting these in twos, okay? Do you want to do it with me? Are you ready to count my 20 Numicon? Let's count them. Are you ready? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Oh dear! I haven't got 20 Numicon. How many have I got? I've got one less than 20. I've got 19 Numicon. And that's not an even number. Why is that not an even number? You're right. This little one doesn't have a partner. Should we give him a partner? Okay, here we go. Are you ready? There we go. Shall we try again? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. Fantastic. Give yourselves a little tiny fairy clap. Brilliant. How have I made 20? How do you know it's 20? Super. We could do 10 add 10 equals 20. Or what else could we do if it's like this? 10 add 9 add 1 equals 20. Fantastic. Have a little think. What other ways can you find that make 20? What other numbers can you put together to make 20? Okay, have a look at all the pictures on this slide and see if you can guess what our shape of the week is. The word is underneath too for those who can read it. It's a 3D shape this week. That means three dimensional. It's a real shape. Last week we looked at a 2D flat shape, which was a square. This week is a real 3D shape. Does anybody know what it's called? A cube. Can you say cube after me? Cube. Super. Right, let's see if there are any similarities between our square last week and our cube this week. What shape face has a cube got? Well done, a square face. So this is your challenge for today, for our shape challenge, okay? I want you to have a look around the house to see if you can find anything that looks like a cube. When you've found something that looks like a cube, have a little look at it and discuss with a grown-up or an older brother or sister all the things you notice about it. I wonder who can count how many square faces a cube has. And I wonder who can explain what a cube looks like and any other properties they can notice. Happy cube hunting, everyone. Have fun. Our word of the week is Easter. It begins with an E, but it's a capital E, which is an E. And it also sounds like an E, Easter. Right, now, Easter is a Christian festival. Mrs. Tolly is Christian, so I celebrate Easter in my house. Now, Easter is one of the oldest Christian celebrated festivals, and it is when Christians think about when Jesus came back to life. So it's a really important time for Christians. Now, at Mrs. Tolly's school, we all have different faiths and different beliefs. But we are super, super special because we are multi-faith. That means we celebrate everyone's religion. OK, so we celebrate all the festivals. We celebrate festivals from Christianity, from Hinduism, from Sikhism, Judaism. We celebrate all of them, which is really, really fab. So this week we're going to be learning a little bit about Easter. Okay, so you'll find out some really, really interesting facts, and we've got some super Easter activities as well. So if you listen to a little bit more of the morning report, you'll see what we are going to be learning about.
Our sign of the week today is the same as our word of the week, okay? It's Easter, and it goes like this. Hold your hand up and across. Easter, making a cross on your hand. Easter, have a go. Easter, fantastic. Okay, our value today is a very, very special one, okay? And we don't normally learn this one this early. We normally learn it in year two or year three, okay? It's a very long word, but it's very, very important at the moment. So we thought we would teach everybody this value today. Our value is gratitude. Does anybody know what gratitude means? Have a little think with your adult. What does it mean? It means being thankful for something, saying thank you, okay? Every day we say thank you, don't we? We say it when somebody opens the door for us or if somebody shares their toys with us. We are thankful, we're showing gratitude, okay? But recently we've been showing gratitude to some really, really important people. Have a think, who might that be? Yes, your mummies and daddies, we're definitely grateful for doing such hard work with you. Who else are we grateful for? Have a little think. I've seen lots of posters and lovely writing already coming from you guys, all about these people. And they're called the NHS, okay? And they are people that work in the hospitals or in the doctor's surgeries, and they look after us when we're poorly, okay? We all know there's some really nasty germs going around at the moment, and it's making people feel really sick and really not good, okay? So we need to show our gratitude to the NHS, okay? And the key workers, everybody that is helping to make people feel better. Okay, lots of you might have gone outside your houses last week and done a great big clap. Okay, if you didn't, should we do a great big one now all together? Are you ready to all of the people that are making us feel better if we get poorly? Are you ready? Do it with me after three. 1, 2, 3. Big clap. Super.
Boys and girls, we are going to use our value of gratitude and show our thanks to Miss Hicks, who has been super, super busy this weekend. Miss Hicks has read us our Easter story, and it is called Saving Easter. So make sure you have a look at our Easter story and listen to it really, really carefully, because our literacy task today is going to be all about saving Easter. Make sure you listen really carefully and ask your grown-up to ask you some questions so that you can answer it. Okay?
Okay, for your well-being activity today, what you need to do is collect some objects or items from around your house and put them under a blanket, okay? This is fun for all of the family, so get everyone involved in this one, okay? When you've got your objects under a blanket, somebody needs to take one item away, okay? And then you look and you have to find which object is missing, okay? Take it in turns with all of your families, with your little brothers, big brothers, little sisters, big sisters, with your mummies, your daddies, your grandparents, everyone in the house. Have a go and practice taking turns. I know that you're going to love this one, hopscotch. We do it at school all the time, okay? So you can practice at home and show everybody at home how good you are at doing it, okay? You can make your hopscotch to number 10, or you could make it to number 20. You could practice hopping on one leg, or you could have a go at throwing a bean bag or a ball onto one of the numbers and then saying the numbers. If you want, you could have a go at throwing a bean bag and a ball, and then adding the two numbers together. You might need a little bit of adult help to do that, okay? Have a little go and see how you get on.
This is our literacy task for today. First of all, before you are able to do this task, you've got to read the story that we have sent to you, okay? If you are on Dojo, then Miss Holly said we'll upload it. If you're accessing this via YouTube, you can get our story link on Facebook, okay? So this is your activity. Miss Hicks and her little boy George spent yesterday making a beautiful story map, okay? Now this is what Miss Hicks has said. Your activity today is to draw a story map of the story Saving Easter. A story map is a way of retelling the story using pictures, just like the pictures in books that help us read stories. Think about what happened in the story and draw a picture of each event in it. Here is my story map that myself and George drew together. He then used the pictures on his story map to help retell the story to his little brother. So you're going to create your own story map. Now, some of you might want to then go on to write some of the story, which is absolutely fine, but your task today is more based about the retelling and the storytelling aspect using your voice, okay? So see if you can make the story map and then retell the story in your own words. We can't wait to see what you've produced. Have a great time and remember your best drawing, please. We want to be able to see what those pictures are. Take care.
For our maths activity today, you need the presentation, which you can find either on our Facebook page or on our Dojo page, okay? Have a little look and open it up. We are telling time with the Easter Bunny, okay? We've had a go already at telling the time. We know that the shorthand tells us what hour it is. How many numbers are there on a round clock, on a circle clock? Can you remember? That's right, there's 12 numbers around, so it goes all the way to 12 o'clock. See if you can tell the time with the Easter Bunny.
Mrs. Tolly is going to use her value of gratitude now. I would like to say a big, big thank you to Miss Hollinshed for making this wonderful PowerPoint. She's rearranged it all and added some beautiful new pictures and slides in, so thank you very much. A big, big thank you to Miss Hicks for telling our story and producing some lovely literacy tasks for us, and also her little helpers, Alfie and George, who have been super busy at home too. I would also like to show my value of gratitude to my boys and girls in school. All of you, all 60 of you who are working so hard at home and who are watching our YouTube channel, thank you so much, and to all the grown-ups for helping you. And one last little shout out to show my gratitude is to my boys and girls, Poppy, Sam and Daisy, for being so, so good during this time we're spending at home. Thank you so much. One extra little shout out, a big shout out to Jack, who is working really hard at home. Jack's been sending his work to me and we've had a look at it and he has produced some amazing work. So thank you, everyone. Let's see if you can use your gratitude today to say thank you to someone and show how grateful you are for everything they do. Right, Mrs. Tolly's off to work today. I'm going into school to help some of the boys and girls who are still coming to us. So I will see you all tomorrow, okay? Take care. Bye.